Trust your first impression. What do you see?
See a tent.
I see a tent. Very good. Tell me more. What does this tent look like?
I'm looking at the tent from the top. It looks like a circus.
Like a circus tent? Mm-hmm. Very good. Tell me more.
Red, blue stripes.
Red and blue stripes? Mm-hmm. What else do you see around besides the tent?
I don't see any. I feel like this activity inside the tent, I don't see anything.
Mm-hmm. So how far up above you are from this tent?
Like 10 feet.
Like 10 feet, you're above it?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more. Are you floating above it?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more. What are you?
A bird.
A bird, very good. Very good. So let's see what you look like. What color are you?
Tan.
Tan, mm-hmm.
Red.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more. Are you a big bird or a little bird?
I'm not little, but I'm not big. Mm-hmm. Just in between.
In between. Can you tell what kind of bird you are?
I think I'm a hawk.
A hawk. Mm. Very good. Are you male or female? Mm-hmm. So let's see what you're doing above this circus tent. What's going through your mind as you're going over it?
The air feels good on my nose.
The air feels good on my nose. Mm-hmm. What else?
I see trees. I think I'm I see trees now.
Okay, let's see where you go. Take me on this journey with you.
It's really green.
Mm. Tell me about this place. Describe it.
It's really thick.
Mm-hmm.
It feels moist.
Mm-hmm. This area where you're in, is it flat or hilly? What does it look like?
Mm.
Look around you. Where are these trees?
Oh, now I see a stream.
Mm-hmm. A stream. Tell me more.
I feel like there's people around.
Mm-hmm. There's people around?
I don't see them, I just feel them.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more. Let's find out where you are. What it looks like.
Hmm. It looks like, oh, it looks like there used to be a lot of trees, but there's a lot of, doesn't feel good. It feels like a lot of trees were cut down.
Mm-hmm.
The earth is bare.
How does that make you feel?
I feel sad.
Tell me more.
There's a lot of sadness.
Mm-hmm. What was it? What were in those trees?
Huh?
Was there anybody that you knew that were in those trees?
No.
Mm, you just feel the sadness of it.
The earth is so bare.
Mm-hmm. Are you connected to the earth? What are you feeling?
So much sadness. What are we doing?
Tell me more.
What are we doing to the earth? Oh, so much sadness. She's alive.
Mm-hmm. The earth is alive. What is she feeling when her trees are cut? Tell me what that pain feels like to her.
Oh, just like I feel pain, she feels it.
Does she say anything when people cut the trees? How does she communicate?
She's still loving.
Mm-hmm.
She's waiting for us to wake up.
Mm-hmm.
We are one. Me and you, we are one. The earth and humanity, we are one.
We are one with the earth and humanity.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What else does Mother Earth say?
I love you. I'm waiting.
What else does she say?
Remember. But I'm in pain.
Mm-hmm. What pain are you in? What's happening to you?
I'm carrying a lot.
Mm-hmm. Where does this pain come from?
Dumping. I see dumping.
Mm-hmm. What's being dumped?
Heavy. Oh, chemicals.
Chemicals. Chemicals dumped in the land?
Yeah.
How does that affect you?
Suffocating. I can't breathe. I can't process. I can't.
What do you do to compensate for that? Is there any way that you adjust?
I see the earth shaking.
The earth is shaking. Is this what the earthquakes are all about?
Yeah, readjustment.
Readjustment. Mm-hmm.
It unnatural. Unnatural.
Mm-hmm. Unnatural. And these readjustments are natural. Is that what you're saying?
Unnatural things.
Unnatural
things. In the earth.
In the, okay. What kind of things are in the earth that are not natural?
I see plastic.
Plastic. Mm-hmm. What else do you see that's hurting you?
Breathing, I can't breathe.
Mm-hmm.
The unnatural things make it hard for Mother Earth to breathe naturally.
Mm-hmm. What kind of things are in the atmosphere now that don't allow you to breathe?
Chemicals.
Mm-hmm.
All the food. Chemicals in the food.
How do you feel about this? These chemicals in the food? How they're being grown now?
It looks real, but it's not real.
It looks real, but it's not?
It's not real food.
What kind of food are we talking about?
Vegetables.
Mm-hmm.
They look like vegetables, but they're not. They're supposed to follow the flower of life.
Mm-hmm.
They're not real.
What is that doing to the people of the world?
Chaos.
Chaos.
It forces you out of alignment.
Mm-hmm.
It affects your brain.
How does it affect your brain?
Chemical imbalance.
And this all comes from the food?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Is there any food that doesn't have chemicals?
Mm. if you grow it. Then you know it's chemical free.
What do you like to be called? What is your name?
Gaia. Gaia.
Gaia, how do you feel about the humans on that live on you? You love the humans?
Yes.
How do you care for them?
I send them my love. I hold them. My heart is real. My heart is powerful. I send them my love.
How do they feel your love?
Touch me. Open up, trust. Spend time with me.
Where do we feel you the best? In the oceans, in the forest? Where? Where can we feel your energy the most?
Everyone is different. Wherever you're called to. The sun, I walk with the sun.
You walk with the sun?
The earth and the sun.
How do you work together?
A triangle.
What do you see?
A triangle.
A triangle?
Yeah.
Who is the triangle between?
The sun, the earth, and the man.
Do we get energy between you and the sun?
Yes. Man's heart is very important.
Man's heart is very important?
Man's part.
Oh, man's part is very important. What does man do? In this triangle.
Portal?
It's a portal.
Of the energy. From the sun.
Do we receive the energy from the sun? And connect with you?
Man processes the energy from the sun and pours it into the earth.
But what if man never goes outside? He's always inside. Is that hurting you?
It would be more powerful if people spend time outside.
Mm-hmm.
It would just help more.
It would help more?
Yeah.
What would it help to do better?
Heal
the earth?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's simple.
So let's say a man is outside in a park receiving energy from the sun. You say he's a portal. Does the sun go through the man and into the earth?
Mm-hmm.
Is there anything coming up from you into the man?
If he's open, yeah.
Mm-hmm. What does he receive from you? We've always heard that you ground people.
Wisdom?
Wisdom?
Yeah. Oh. The information, the wisdom activates each person's unique codes.
Each person's unique what?
Each person's unique. Oh. I see equations.
Equations, codes. Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. Spending time in nature with your feet on me activates the real undistorted you.
The real what?
The real undistorted.
Undistorted? View?
You.
Oh,
unique,
you.
Unique, yeah.
Oh, the uniqueness of us.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So we are all working together. Man has to understand he's very important.
Mm-hmm.
Whole equation. Nothing is too little.
Mm-hmm. Now what happens, Gaia, when we cut down all of these forests? How does that affect you? For example, the Amazon being cut down to raise cattle. Or being used for wood.
Unnatural, out of balance.
Mm-hmm. What emotions do you feel? Because I know you love man so much, but man is the one doing this to you. How do you forgive them for that?
A mother forgives. But the earth is heavy, it's heavy.
What can we do to lift it for you?
S- live a simple life.
Live a simple life.
Cutting down trees to create what you think is more. It's not about more. It's so distorted.
Gaia, I've been told that a new earth is being created, that you are transforming. This is true. Are you evolving?
Yes.
What's happening to you energetically?
I'm refining. I'm refining my energy.
Mm-hmm. What does this energy feel like, this new one?
Like I can breathe.
How do you do this?
I don't do it alone. Man is so important. The sun. And the sun, the bigger sun.
Is this the central sun? What does the central sun have to do with you and man?
Oh, we're coming back into alignment. I see a corridor of light.
A corridor of light? Tell me more. Where is it coming from?
From the big sun.
The big sun?
Yeah.
Not our sun.
Both.
Both. And what does this corridor of light have?
I see a new earth.
You see a new earth?
It already exists.
Tell me about this. Where is it?
Here.
Tell me more. Is this a new and improved Gaia? Or a different one?
Different expressions of her.
Like a different aspect of her?
Yeah.
What is this new earth expressed like?
Light. Geometry.
And geometry.
Yeah.
What does the geometry do?
Alignment.
Alignment. Tell me more.
Hmm. I see. I see different versions of Gaia dancing.
Different versions of Gaia dancing?
They move together.
They move together. Hmm. How many are there?
I see six.
Six of them? Six different versions of Gaia?
They're all connected.
Hmm. Are they next to each other?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So much love.
Tell me about this love that you feel.
The waiting, oh my God, everything is spinning.
Everything is spinning?
Yeah.
In what way?
Oh. Oh wow.
What do you see? What do you experience?
Like I'm Gaia, I'm moving with the other Earths.
Mm-hmm.
It's spinning so fast, so fast. Oh, the vibration is getting stronger and stronger.
Mm-hmm. Is this vibration spinning all of you together?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Is it around you?
Oh, wow. Ooh, yeah.
Tell me, how does it feel?
The whole earth is moving faster and faster.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, shaking everything off. The faster I move, the... Oh my God, ooh.
What do you see?
I'm just spinning so fast.
What's that causing?
Oh my God.
Does that affect man?
Yes, yes, yes.
Tell me what's happening.
Disorientation.
Disorientation?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And everything that is not I see sacred geometry. Everything that is not real is shaking off.
Anything
it's
that's
coming
not,
up.
It's coming up?
Yeah.
By real, do you mean like buildings and things like that?
Anything that is not in alignment with Source, I see the Big Sun.
Mm-hmm.
Everything that is not in alignment with the Sun.
Mm-hmm.
It's shaking off.
What? Does this include man?
Mm-hmm.
So if you're not in alignment with the sun, the central sun, you're shaken off of it?
Yeah.
What does it look like to you?
Oh. Being in alignment with the source?
Mm-hmm.
Causes stillness.
Mm.
No more disorientation. What is not real is gonna become very apparent.
Mm-hmm.
And there's gonna be a lot of chaos.
Mm-hmm.
But the chaos helps. The chaos helps.
How does it help?
To remember. To remember to remember the truth.
Mm-hmm.
I keep saying the sun, the great central sun.
The great central sun.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What kind of chaos are we talking about, Gaia? Physical, emotional, political?
Everything. All man-made creations.
Mm-hmm.
Meant to keep people oppressed.
Mm-hmm. What's going to happen to it?
Disruption.
Mm-hmm.
It's falling apart.
And what happens to man that is aligned?
You teach love. Love.
Gaia, what happens to the other Earths? Does anybody inhabit those?
Mm-hmm.
Who inhabits those Earths? Those different aspects of you? Those different expressions?
It's a choice.
Mm. How do we get from one Earth to the other?
Alignment.
Alignment. Is this a vibrational alignment or?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Align with love.
Align with love.
Not perfection.
Mm-hmm.
Love.
So if we align with love, we'll go to the new Earth.
It's a vibration.
Mm-hmm.
So yes.
Very good. And what happens to you on this Earth, Gaia?
I wait.
What do you wait for?
I wait for everyone to awaken.
Mm-hmm. To awaken?
To awaken.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm not alone.
Tell me more about that. Is somebody helping you awaken? What do you see?
I have a... It's not a twin. I have different versions of myself, but I have a twin.
Mm-hmm. Where is this twin? Is she attached to you?
No.
Where is she? What do you see?
I feel Oh. Trying to, I'm in space.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it feels very solid. I don't know what this is.
Tell me more.
I haven't been discovered.
You haven't been discovered?
It's so solid. Oh my God.
What are you?
It feels magnetic. It's oh my God. It's oh.
Tell me more. Describe yourself for me.
I can't see, I just feel.
Mm-hmm. What do you feel like?
I'm very solid, like a magnet. I'm very. Oh, I have a very powerful magnetic force field.
Mm-hmm. What do you look like?
I see blue.
Mm-hmm. What are you?
A star.
A star?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Are you a blue star?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Do you have a name?
This is serious.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I'm so dead. I'm so powerful.
You're so powerful?
The energy is so powerful.
Mm-hmm.
I see my mom.
Mm-hmm. What is she doing? What is your mom doing?
My mom has authority over us.
Mm-hmm. What does she do to you?
I see her yelling.
Mm-hmm.
Yelling and standing on top of us, above us.
Above you? Mm-hmm. What year is this for you?
1498.
What country are you in?
Turkey.
Turkey? Mm-hmm. Tell me more about your life. Who are you?
I think I'm a child.
Mm-hmm.
And my dad is my brother.
Mm-hmm. And you're both chained?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What is the reason why you're chained?
I get done working, we get back, we get chained so we can't run away.
Who is the one that chains you? Is this someone who owns you?
Mm-hmm.
Is it a male or female?
Both.
There's two people or one?
Two.
Two? Mm-hmm. How old are you there?
Seven.
Mm-hmm. So let's see what happens next. Close that scene and go to another important scene in that lifetime. See what happens. What happens?
I'm swimming.
Mm-hmm.
Running away.
You're swimming and running away?
There's someone with me, someone. But they don't make it.
What happens to you?
I'm swimming. Oh, I'm so scared.
You can watch it as an observer and see what happens.
I swam and they didn't make it.
Didn't make it?
I made it, but
the other one didn't?
No.
Where are you now?
It looks like a beach.
A beach? Mm-hmm. Where do you go?
I see a little hat. I see something I'm walking towards, but
mm-hmm.
I'm scared of being taken again.
What happens? What do you do? What do you see?
To my left, I see what's a lagoon.
A lagoon?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What else do you see around you?
Not a lot. Some people, but I don't trust.
Mm-hmm. Let's see what happens next. Advance the scene to where something happens.
I think I'm tired of living.
Mm-hmm.
I find a place.
Where do you go?
I see a little bit of bush or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
Washed up like trees or something.
Mm-hmm.
I find a spot and I go in there and I just lay down and I give up.
Mm-hmm. So let's see where it happens to you next. Every lifetime has a purpose and has a lesson. What was the purpose of that lifetime? What were you supposed to learn?
Loss.
What were you supposed to learn?
Loss.
Lost?
Lost.
Lust?
Lost.
Oh, lost. You're lost?
Losing someone.
Losing someone. Mm-hmm. You're supposed to learn loss. Loss of what? Freedom? Or people?
People.
Mm. Who did you lose?
He felt like a brother, but I don't know.
Mm-hmm. How are you affecting the life right now of Shiro? How is that loss affecting her from your lifetime?
Fear of loss, fear of loving.
Fear of loss and of loving?
Mm-hmm.
What would you like to tell her?
You're free.
Mm-hmm.
You're free, you're not chained. You broke free.
Mm-hmm. Do we need to heal that little boy who gave up?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So I'd like for you to feel my hand on your chest, and as I do, I want you to give me all of those feelings of hopelessness, of loss, of not being free. Give them all to me. You don't need to hold that in your memory any longer. Allow all of those feelings to come out of you. Breathe them out of every cell. Tell me when I have it all. Very good. I'm taking it and sending it off to the universe. Now in that space, what would you like to put instead?
Trust.
Let's put lots of trust in there. Feel that trust in yourself and in others. And I'm going to touch your forehead and seal that in. What else would you like to put in there?
Warmth.
Lots of warmth. And with that warmth, let's put lots of love in there. Lots of love and warmth. And seal that in. What else would you like to put in there?
Joy.
Let's put lots of joy. A little boy should always feel joyful and free to express himself. Mm-hmm. Anything else you'd like to put in there?
Playfulness.
Mm-hmm. Let's put lots of playfulness, because little boys need to play. Feel it going in there. All that playfulness. Be able to laugh, sing, run around like a child again. Feel it going in there. And let's seal that. How does it feel now? Very good. Is there anything that you, any advice that you would like to give Shiro now that you have all of that joy in your heart?
It's okay to trust and live life to the fullest.
Very good.
You're free.
Thank you. And I'd like to have you cut free from her life now. Now that she doesn't need that memory anymore, cut yourself free from that life. You will find peace. You will find what you need to find. Thank you very much. I know you could have shown her many different lifetimes today. And you chose to show her one of a bird and then of Gaia. Why did you show her that life?
Because it's so cool. Because we're all connected.
We're all connected.
Whatever we do to the earth affects everything. That connection is very powerful. If used for good as well.
That connection is very powerful if used for good as well. In what way can we use that connection?
It's so simple. We're all one.
We're all one.
No need to complicate things, bitches. We're all one, we're connected.
Why do we feel so separate, though, from each other?
Infiltration?
From what?
Outside sources.
Outside sources? Where do they come from?
Other places. They teach competition.
These other places, are they other planets or other beings?
Other beings from other planets.
They're the ones who complicate things for us.
But we allow.
We allow them to?
Yeah.
How do they infiltrate us? Do we see them?
The things you allow in your field. Things you watch.
Like TV? Movies?
Games?
Main video games?
Yeah.
They all infiltrate through that?
Yeah. Vibration?
Yes. What
it's
else?
It's a choice.
It's a choice. So a choice, for example, not to watch TV keeps those intentions away? Or that vibration away?
What you watch.
What you watch, okay.
It's choice, but every choice has a fruit.
Yes, an outcome.
Yeah.
It's like a seed that you plant.
Yeah.
What's the best seeds that we could plant?
Simple.
Simple life?
Yeah. Love.
Love.
Connecting.
Why did you show her the life of that star?
Home.
That's her home?
One of them.
She's been very connected to that star, hasn't she?
Yeah.
She wanted to hear a message from it. What message did that star want to give her?
It The trust.
The trust? Are there any dolphins on that star? Or in that area?
Yeah, but they're not.
She has a connection with dolphins.
Yes, they. The dolphins. Sound.
Sound.
Healing with sound.
The dolphins heal with their sound? Is that why they're here on this earth?
The healing earth.
They're healing earth with their sound?
Yeah. They're teaching humanity how to heal with sound.
Okay. Do they emit some sort of frequency that we hear internally?
Yes.
Is there any other information about the dolphins that you would like us to know?
They could use our support.
Well, it seems the dolphins are probably suffering too with all of the plastic in the oceans and all of the explosions that they hear and things like that. How can we help?
Listen. Trust what you hear. They're teaching how to heal.
Okay. Do we heal the dolphins even if we're not by the water?
Yeah. We're not separate from the dolphins.
We're all one.
Yeah.
Okay. Good. Thank you very much. She had a question about light language. What can you tell her about that?
A first language.
That's her first language?
Yeah.
Where does that light language come from?
From her higher self that is on Sirius.
Okay. Does she understand that? Okay, good. Does she have any connection with an Andromeda?
Travels.
Does she travel there?
Yeah.
In what way?
Learning.
What is it?
Learning.
She learns there?
Yeah.
Okay. Good. What would be a good job for her to align with this
with the soul calling. Can you tell her that?
She doesn't trust.
She doesn't trust. So, everything that she needs to do is based on trust? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Is that where she makes her mistakes?
Yeah.
In trusting herself? Okay. When we're talking about trust, what is what the picture of what's actually happened to her at work? What is she learning from this?
Let it be.
Let it be. Yeah. Okay. She needs to just look the other way.
Let it be.
Let it be. Does she understand that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good. She says that she has a very deep fear of losing her mother. And she's seen herself at her grave. She wants to know if there's a past life connection there. We've already seen her as a young boy in Turkey. What connection does she have with her mom in that grave? What's the fear all about? Fear of standing up?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
On her own.
Mm-hmm. So if she stands up on her own, her mother is not needed in her life, is that it? It's like losing her mother?
Yeah.
Or does she lose a connection?
Approval. She lose the approval.
Ah. So what does she need to do?
Stand up.
Stand up for herself, trust herself.
Yeah.
It's not really that she's losing her mother. It's that she's losing her approval.
Yeah.
Okay. But she's a woman now. She doesn't need her mother's approval.
No.
Okay. Good. Good. What is a lesson or karma connected to that land?
It was taken. From her family.
Mm-hmm. What do you see?
Dowry.
A dowry?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What happened?
My dad is a woman.
Mm-hmm.
My mom is a man. Something about dowry.
Mm-hmm. Was that land the dowry?
No, but
What happened?
It's so muddled. It's so many streams.
Mm-hmm.
Something went wrong.
And what happened?
Oh, God. Someone died?
Mm-hmm.
This blood.
Whose blood is this?
This blood, oh my God, this blood.
Did someone get killed?
Yeah.
Over what?
Land.
Over land.
The blood is in the land.
Okay.
Oh, someone was killed for the land?
Mm-hmm. And is he still there?
He's stuck.
He's stuck there. We need to get him moving. Let's find out who this man is.
Oh my God.
What do you see?
His body was cut in half.
Yes, I figured. Mm-hmm.
The blood went into the land.
All right. So let's call the soul of that man. We need to get him healed. Call the soul of that man and let me speak with him. Good evening. I understand that you've had an accident there. You've lost the connection to your body. Mm-hmm. What happened to you?
They lied
to you.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And they severed your body?
Yeah.
And you'll never rest, will you, until that body is healed?
Yeah.
All right, I want you to take your body and look at it and see how it's cut. And I want you to use your energy to bring that body together again. Make it whole. Tell me when it's in one piece. Is it in one piece?
Mm-hmm.
All right, now I'd like for you to use a device to bring up all of that blood. All of the blood on the ground, bring it up and put it back in that body. See that blood going back into that body so that the land is clean. Now that you have your body whole and the blood within it, I want you to tell me how you feel. How does that feel to you?
Thank you.
All right, now I'd like for the angels of the light to surround you and fill you with love. How do you feel?
Thank you.
All right, I'm going to ask Archangel Michael to take you by the hand and escort you up to the light. You are whole again. You can now bless that land and make it prosperous and make it happy now that you are free. Tell me when you get to the light.
Yeah.
Thank you. How does that feel?
Free.
Very good. Now that you're free, I'd like for you to look at that land and see if there are any other brothers there that need to come with you. Any others that are lost like you. Oh. What do you see? How many do you see?
A lot. Mm-hmm. None of them.
Tell them how to make themselves whole again. You can tell them now. And tell them to come with you. Tell them to come with you.
Oh, they're coming.
Mm-hmm. How many are there?
Wow. Babies.
Mm-hmm. Clear that land. Bring them all with you. We're going to have the angels surround you. There's going to be thousands of angels escorting all of you up to the light.
Oh.
What do you see?
So happy.
Mm-hmm. Tell me when they've all gone to the light. Clear that land. And you can spread that light even further. You can spread it out even farther beyond that land. You can call them in the entire city, in the entire country. Bring them all up to you. Call them to you. See all of those angels escorting them. What do you see?
I see a blanket of so many souls. So many stuck, stuck souls.
No, now they're not stuck. Call them to you. Bring them all up. Let's lift that whole nation of souls. Let's clear Kenya of all the lost souls. What do you see?
Jubilation. They're happy to be free.
Of course.
Freedom, freedom, freedom.
And now that that land is free, I'm going to ask for the light to shine down on that land, making it prosperous, making it grow, bringing happiness and joy to the people of that land, feeling that freedom, knowing that now they are free, the land is happy again. Shine that light on that land. Very good. Are they all gone now? They all into light?
Yes.
Very good. Let me speak with the higher self. Now that we've re-energized that land, I want you to look around and see if Guka John made it to the light.
He just did.
Very good.
He just did.
Wonderful. Yeah. He was stuck too, wasn't he?
Yeah.
Wonderful. Can you tell Shiru
What is it that she's feeling in her body? She feels as if there's things crawling all over her body, pests or parasites. What's her body dealing with? What's it trying to tell her? Are these actual insects or energy? What is it?
It was connected to the land.
It was connected to the land. Mm-hmm. And what happened? Why was she connected to it?
Old attachments.
Old attachments? Mm-hmm. Are they gone now?
Yeah.
Very good. Would you please fill her with light? Fill her with that healing light. So she doesn't feel that anymore. Cut her free from all of that. Is it all cut from her? Detach? Very good. Very good. She told me that she had a dream once and she felt as if her hair was pulled out and the roots were golden dog paws. What was that all about?
Rituals?
Rituals?
Yeah.
What kind of rituals?
Binding
rituals?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. From what life?
Ouch.
What was it? Was somebody binding her?
She took part in a ritual?
Mm-hmm.
That came back to be cleared.
Mm-hmm. What kind of ritual was it?
It's connected to the land.
Again?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Have we disconnected from that now?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So these were all things that were happening in that land that she was experiencing?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Was she experiencing herself, or was she getting messages from those that were there? Was she channeling them?
She was open.
She was receiving?
Yeah.
Just like she received from Gaia?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Is there anything that we didn't ask today that you would like to tell her? Hmm. For example, why did you bring her here today? She came all this way?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
She was brought here. Just learning how to trust guidance.
Learning how to trust guidance.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, we had a long conversation about how to trust guidance.
Yeah.
For hypnosis.
Yeah.
Can she use that same advice for other things in her life?
Yes.
The beautiful dance of life.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What else would you like to tell her besides trust?
Enjoy life.
Enjoy life. Very good. Is there any message that you would like to tell anybody else?
Thank you, Alba. For connecting so many people and healing.
Thank you. I give credit to all of my guides and higher self for that. They guide me. Thank you very much. Are we complete today? Thank you. Welcome back. What a journey. What a journey.
Wow.
What do you feel?
I feel good.
You gotta talk louder now. I don't have my headset on.
I feel good.
You feel good?
Gooey.
Gooey. You feel gooey?
Like all one.
All one. Hmm. How did it feel like to be Gaia?
Oh, wow. In the beginning, it was so much pain.
Yes. A lot of pain there.
And love, too.
Mm-hmm. You know? It was beautiful. What a beautiful thing to witness.
Yeah. Oh, mm. Yeah. Oh, yeah, the bird was watching.
Yes.
I was a bird.
You were a bird first, and then you just went over an area that was being cut.
Yeah.
And that's where the crying began.
Yeah, like an open wound.
Like a wound, yes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. How long do you feel you were on this journey?
25 minutes?
No. An hour and 45 minutes.
Really?
Well, right now, yes. You were gone for a while. And what do you remember?
It feels like 25 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
I remember the earth. And then I remember, oh yeah, that the man who was cut in half.
Yes.
And then when he became whole,
mm-hmm.
I saw all these people, they looked like shadows.
Mm-hmm. Like shadows, yeah.
And they had their hands up and they just kept coming and coming. And it was not just that piece of land, it was a lot.
And they kept going?
Yeah, they just...
Like, started going?
Like a pipeline.
Oh boy.
Yeah.
We did a little land clearing, huh?
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Wow.
So do you want to share some of this? It was unbelievable. We'll cut out everything that's personal.
Personal.
Of
yeah.
course.
Yeah.
But the part about Gaia and the star.
That, like, yeah, that star is so powerful.
Mm, magnetic.
Oh my God.
Those parts were unbelievable. That's the part I'm talking about.
Yeah.
And I think the clearing of the land was good, too.
Yeah.
That was good. Everything else is personal. We cut that out.
Okay.
Okay, good? Excellent. Let me disconnect you here and let's sit down and we could say goodbye. All right. Wow. Wow. That's all I can say. Wow.
Wow. Yeah.
Wow. I was witnessing this and it was, wow. I couldn't believe it.
You could see it, right?
Yeah, I feel it.
Yeah.
I mean, the pain of Gaia was so much.
And you were just pouring your heart out, and you could feel.
Yeah.
There was so much love, and there was so much talk about this, these other Earths, and
yeah,
that was what was that?
It almost feels like if you were to draw six circles.
Yes.
Or six spheres.
Yes.
And they're all like working together.
Yeah.
So no Earth is being left behind.
Wow.
And I couldn't verbalize at the time, but that's what the love is like. They're all working together.
So it was all like a vibration of love spinning around?
Yes.
And what was really confusing was the part about the fact that whoever is not in alignment or not is not going to make it. Like anything that was not real.
What I was trying to say is anything that is not natural and organic is what's causing the distortion.
Yes.
You know? Like I think we talked about fake food.
Fake food, yes. Yeah, that everything was fake.
Yeah, and how it affects
our mind.
It causes confusion.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There was so much in this.
I'll have to watch it again. A little bit is coming back.
Well, now. You thought you were only out for 25 minutes.
Yeah.
So,
wow.
So and also we talked about the clearing of that land, which was.
Yes. Wow.
That was amazing.
Yeah, and so much. People like. Energy gets stuck when land is fought over.
Okay, so all those people who died for that land basically were stuck there.
Yeah, like freedom fighters, people fighting for freedom.
So you actually saw them.
Yeah, like a pipeline, so many of them, so many of them. And it just started by that one, the first one who was cut in half.
Yes.
When he healed, he freed others.
Yeah. That's a beautiful thing.
Yeah.
That's amazing. That's great.
Yeah.
Now, the one that was very sad was the one about the little boy. That it was like you and your father in a past life, and you were chained as little boys.
Yeah.
And you would do your chores and then be chained up again, almost like animals.
Yeah.
And then you finally escape, but
he didn't make it.
No.
Yeah. And I think after he didn't make it, I just gave up.
Right.
I went on there.
Yes. And it almost felt as if, you know, that was affecting your life now.
Yeah, definitely.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So now that you've experienced this, and I always tell everybody, no matter what you come here for, you're going to leave with something different.
Yeah.
You never come here. You never leave
with
what you came here for. So you came with very few questions, but boy, you got so many more answers.
I was having a hard time formulating the questions. And
uh-huh.
I'm kind of glad I didn't, because then it just allowed. Because it feels like it was just all one
answer?
Yeah.
Like one thing.
Everything connects to everything.
Right, right. And sometimes people who have the least amount of questions have really better sessions, because it leaves it open.
Yeah.
And your higher self is really taking control and saying, well, this is what I want to tell you.
Yeah. Trust. I kept hearing
that. Trust. It was like over and over again. That was like the undermining thing. So we're here in Elizabeth, New Jersey. And how far did you drive?
2.5 hours.
Yeah, from Pennsylvania.
Pennsylvania, yeah.
Yeah, so she kind of crossed the state and came over here. So how would you experience, how would you explain the experience of hypnosis to everybody, for you?
It's very natural. It's, you know what, it's very natural. It's very easy to get into. You have to trust, you know what I mean?
There you go.
Yeah.
The first lesson today was trust me.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And it just happened so naturally. And you know what surprised me was that my mind was not too active. You know, I could hear it a little bit, but just the experience, the feeling was so strong.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That you kind of were flowing with it.
Yeah.
Excellent. Do you recommend this?
Oh, yes. Definitely.
How would you prepare for this? How would you tell everybody to prepare for this session?
Be open and be excited about it, you know.
Don't dread it.
No, there's nothing to dread. There's nothing to dread.
Well, some people are afraid of what they're going to see. I've heard people say, I'm really afraid because I feel like, what if I see something scary?
But even if you see that something scary, you're so safe because you feel the angels, you feel your higher self. So if you're seeing it, it's because you're ready to move on.
Right. And I've received phone calls from people saying I've had past life regression before, but I stopped it because I saw something I didn't want to see.
Mm.
And I think that's right when you're seeing it is something that needs to be healed.
To be healed, yes.
So we need to get past that and find out why you're seeing it, because there's a healing that needs to be done. Cool. Well, if you want a session with me, you can go to albaweinman.com, my website. All the communication should be done through there. That's the best way. And hopefully I will see you at another time. I do travel like we are doing right now. And we'll see each other next time, okay? Bye. Give me that hug.
Thank you so much.
Oh, you're welcome. That was so good.
So good.